be to God. Father, we thank you for yet another opportunity to learn at your feet. We bless your name, O God, for feeding us with your words. Lord, as we listen this time, O God, we pray that you bless us through your words. Establish us, O God, in faith. And at the end of our race here on earth, help us to reign with you. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I want to appreciate you for taking our time to listen to us. I pray that the Lord will bless you, the Lord will establish you, the Lord will prosper your way in Jesus' name. Please, as you listen and you are being blessed, don't forget to share with others. And if you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel, please subscribe at Timothy Fuller and Saul, and the Lord bless you as you do so in the name of Jesus. Exodus chapter 2, verse 11. Exodus chapter 2, verse 11. Now it came to pass in those days, when Moses was grown, that he went out to his brethren and looked at their burdens. And he saw an Egyptian beating a Hebrew, one of his brethren. Verse 12. So he looked this way and that way. And when he saw no one, he killed the Egyptian and hid him in the sand. We started a series in the last video, Zeal is Not Enough. And under this series, we are going to look at this subtopic, Grown but Not Groomed. Grown but not groomed. In verse 11 of Exodus chapter 2, now it came to pass in those days when Moses was grown. In those days when Moses was grown. Before you can say someone grew, there are a lot of observation. There are a lot of things, features that you will notice on that person. It could be in size. It could be in experience. It could be in terms of knowledge. It could be in terms of getting used to an environment, getting used to a system. He was used to the system in Egypt. He knew that he was not part of these people. He knew himself to be a Hebrew. He was grown. He was trained in Egypt. He was trained even in the palace. He was used to the system. He had opportunities to walk to the field and see how people were faring there. And he discovered that his people were maltreated. He was grown. There is this mindset, there is this feeling that I don't belong to these people. I belong to these people. He was grown. But was he really groomed? And if he was groomed, in what direction? By who? You know, the training that Moses had up to that time was the training in the palace. Fine, his mother trained him when he was young. But the mother has handed him over to the daughter of Pharaoh. So they trained him, probably understood the language. He was putting on their uniform. He was doing things like the Egyptians. He was grown, but he was not groomed. When you say somebody is groomed, you see, it means to prepare someone, maybe for an appointment or for election. There are other definitions of grooming, but this is the one that relates to what we want to discuss. Moses was grown. Grooming involves preparation. Involves discipleship, they involve anointing, it involves encounter, it involves building testimony. It is very good. There are a lot of description about growth in the Bible. We had the one of Samuel in 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 26. He grew and he found favor with man and with God. In 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 19, 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 19, and Samuel grew. And the Lord was with him. Look at the description of the growth of Samuel. What of the growth of John the Baptist? His own description in Luke chapter 1 verse 80. And the child grew and waxed strong in spirit and was in the desert till the day of his sowing unto Israel. That was that of John the Baptist. What about the description of the growth system of our Lord Jesus Christ? In Luke chapter 2 verse 40. Luke chapter 2 verse 40. And the child grew and waxed strong in spirit, filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was upon him. Now going back to that of Moses. Moses, when Moses was grown, that he went out. When Moses was grown, this description was different from other description, that of Samuel, that of John the Baptist, that of Jesus Christ. What was lacking in the description of Moses? There was no grooming. There was no what? No grooming. You see, God will not use a man that he has not groomed. If you are going to be effective in the service of God, grooming is very crucial. You see, when you When you lack grooming, there are some things that will happen in your life. What are the implications? Let's look at it. I'll give you about four implications of growth without grooming. When you are just described as someone that is growing and no grooming, what are things that will happen? There will be premature appearance. There will be what? Premature appearance. Was seen in the life of Moses. When Moses was grown, what happened? What follows that? He went out. He appeared as the savior of Israel. Meanwhile, he lacked grooming. So when you lack grooming and all you have is just growth, we have what you call premature appearance. There are some people today, maybe you were given opportunity to lead prayer. And somebody came and said, the prayer you led yesterday, as you just mentioned this thing, that was the thing I was actually experiencing. And that thing just disappeared. I was ill. Glory be to God. That is growth. There is still a place of grooming. That is not enough for you to go and say, I have a ministry. Let me go and start my own. If you are just growing without being groomed by God, you might not last. You appear prematurely and you end up becoming a murderer. And what will happen? Eventually, you will run away. So one thing that will happen if you are just growing without being groomed is that you have a premature appearance. Second thing that will happen is that there will be what we call concern not backed up with communion. Concern not backed up with communion. Moses saw the burden of the Hebrew. He was concerned about it. That why will my people be going through this suffering? But there was no communion to back it up. You see, your concern about what is going on is not enough. If you lack communion with God, communion with the Holy Spirit, that concern will just be empty. It won't be sustained. It is the communion with the Holy Spirit that will sustain the concern we have about the lost. It is good that you have concern about the work of God. You want to do it. You just want to throw yourself into the work of God, into the service of God. But if you lack communion, time will come, you begin to complain. You will see your pastor as your problem. You see other ministers, other workers as your problem. That is concern without communion. You must not neglect the place of communion, which is an aspect of grooming. You can be groomed in the place of communion. Communion with God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So when you are just growing without being groomed, what will happen is that you will have just concern, mere concern, that is not backed up with communion. Another thing that will happen if a man is growing without being groomed is that there will be discovery without empowerment. Discovery without empowerment. You see, he saw that the Israelites they were being in slavery, and that was not enough. Right there and then, he saw that an Egyptian was maltreating the Hebrew. And he was moved, concerned. He discovered this. This is supposed not to be so. He discovered himself that I think I have a role to play in the life of these people. But honestly speaking, there was no empowerment. Why not wait for empowerment? It is empowerment that will bring meaning to your discovery. Discovery without empowerment will lead to frustration, will lead to disaster, will lead to disagreement. Because the second day when he got there, there was a disagreement. There was a disagreement between himself, Moses, and even the Hebrew that he was fighting for. So when you just are just moving by discovery, say, this place, there is no church here. So let me start a church here. That's a discovery. You need to go for empowerment. Don't play with empowerment. You need to be empowered. That is why Jesus told the disciples, say, don't go, tarry ye at the upper room until you are empowered. They have discovered that Jesus is going and they need to take the place. They need to represent Jesus here on earth. Fantastic discovery. But Jesus warned them. He said, don't go until you are what? Empowered. The fourth thing that will happen when a man is growing without being groomed is that there will be fear and physical approach to spiritual matters. Moses looked this way and that way. That symbolizes fear. He was afraid. Maybe someone was looking. And do you know what? Someone was actually looking because they got to know. They knew that Moses was the one that killed the Egyptians. The following day when he got there and saw the Israelites, That one told them, I said, who made you prince and judge over us? You want to kill me the way you killed the Egyptians yesterday? So he was like, so this thing was known. So there will be fear if you are just growing and you are not being groomed. There will be fear. And you will be approaching spiritual things with physical things. And that's, the Bible says, by strength shall no man prevail. So he killed with his hands. You see, you can't do the work of God with your mere hands. You need God. And you can only find God when you submit yourself to be groomed by him. If you have no connection with Jesus, you have not even started. Your growth is just like a plant that you put enough fertilizer or all this chicken that they put injection so that it will just grow. After 3 months, they sell it and get money. Maybe you are being trained to be treated later. You need Jesus in your life. Pray this prayer with me and say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. Be my Lord and my Savior. Write my name in the book of life. Forgive me all my sins, O Lord. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I pray for you, it shall be well with you. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will prosper you. He will make things work to your favor. And you will make it to the end. As from today, you will submit yourself even to the grooming by the Almighty God. And those instruments that the Lord wants to use to groom you, may you not miss them in the mighty name of Jesus. And you will be useful in its ends. And you will finish strong in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. God bless you. See you next week by God's grace.
I'm a product of grace.